Hey everyone, in this video we're going to take a look at the new and improved AccuLips feature for lip syncing and lip animations with the iClone 7.8 update. This feature allows for more accurate and detailed visemes when doing lip sync, as well as smoother lip animations. Please be aware that only CC1, CC3, CC3+, and game bases are compatible with this feature, and it currently only supports the English language. We'll cover the more advanced features in future tutorials, but the intention of this video is just to cover the basics. Let's get started with this handsome-looking toon-style character on the screen. I mentioned earlier about the compatible bases. You can convert to a game base in the Attributes tab, where you'll find a big button there that allows you to do so. For custom CC3+ characters, you'll need to find a CC3+ template, which can be found in your Smart Gallery. In this case, we only want to activate the viseme checkbox. We'll cover the other two in the ARKit tutorial. Once that's been applied, let's take a look at where to find the AccuLips feature. With your character selected, you'll find it under the Animation tab once you click on the Create Script tool in the Facial section, alongside all of the other previously available Create Script options, such as recording your voice, text-to-speech, and importing audio file or a previously saved script file. You'll see a completely new AccuLips UI appear. Notice at the top, it indicates the name of the current character we have selected. And there are also some import audio buttons right beside that, which we'll discuss in a bit. An alternate way to start up the AccuLips panel is to go to the animation file menu, create script, and then select AccuLips from there. The import audio methods are the same here. We have the option to import an audio file, record our voice live, or use computer-generated text-to-speech. In this quick example, I'm going to import an audio file that I already have prepared. Once we load it up, you'll see the wavelength of the audio will appear in the AccuLips panel timeline. If you play back, then the audio will play back. However, your lip sync won't be applied just yet.
You can import a prepared script and get more precise lip syncing. Create incredibly natural speaking, like a real person, with a co-articulation design, and be able to further fine-tune every word's visemes and strength level.
You can click the Generate Text button in order to produce text from this voice. You'll see each word align with the wavelength in the timeline and the entire monologue appear in the box below.
You can import a prepared script and get more precise lip syncing. Create incredibly natural speaking like a real person.
There may be small discrepancies that arise between the audio file and the text, which we'll discuss more in the advanced tutorials. For now, let's just go down to apply. Once we do, you'll see the main timeline becomes populated with the clip, audio wavelength, and viseme keyframes that you may be familiar with, the difference being that the audio wavelength track now also contains the words as well as the wavelength. From there, just go ahead and play back to see the results.
You can import a prepared script and get more precise lip syncing. Create incredibly natural speaking like a real person with a co-articulation design and be able to further fine-tune every word's visemes and strength level.
Finally, let's take a quick look at how to convert the lip sync result from an old project. Here I have a character with a lip sync from an older version.
The rise of the digital human has many examples. However, iClone and Character Creator are the tools that actually make you the creator.
To convert it to an AccuLips result, you'll first need to right-click in the voice track and select AccuLips. As before, it will show an audio wavelength in the new AccuLips panel, and you can then generate the text from there.
The rise of the digital human has many examples. However, iClone and Character Creator are the tools that actually make you the creator.
If you're satisfied with the text, then you can just go ahead and apply to see the full result.
The rise of the digital human has many examples. However, iClone and Character Creator are the tools that actually make you the creator.
That's it for this brief introduction, guys. From here, you can try it out on your own, and come back to the more advanced tutorial to learn more about the various ways you can edit and further refine the results.